Hey guys, this is your captain speaking. Salt speaking, and my oh my, has it been a bit since we've done one of these? Definitely some months. I love doing these. I pretty much just wait until someone's like, hey, when are you gonna do another Pokemon card opening video? And then I'm like, yes, thank you. And then I immediately order Pokemon cards. If no one ever asks, then it's just me doing it for myself. But as long as somebody asks for it, I'm just doing it for the fans, alright? This is just for the fans. I get nothing out of this. No personal enjoyment, trust me. So I ordered 8 packs. I usually do about 8 packs. I know there's videos people doing the big booster boxes or whatever. Those are like $100. And I'm not at a stage in my life where I should or can or want to spend $100 on Pokemon cards. So unless this video gets 1 million views, I probably won't be doing anything more than 8 packs ever. So sorry. But bless those people that do those booster box packs, because I love watching those. So we have 8 packs today. 10 cards each, as you know. And I was surprised because I always order the same thing. It's just from Pokemon, but it's on Amazon. And they sell 4 packs, just 4 random packs, for like anywhere from $12 to $16. And it fluctuates. So I try to buy it when it's towards $12, because that means these packs are like $3 each, which is pretty good, because like in the store they're 4 or 5. So, but it's random packs is the key word there. Where you can get, you know, XY generations, you can get, you know, Roaring Skies, whatever, what have you. These are all Sun and Moon, and I'll read them to you. Some of these are actually ones I haven't seen before. Celestial Storm. Guess I can do some crinkling with that. Celestial Storm, we got 2 of those. And then we've got, I believe, 2 of these Burning Shadows. Celestial Storm. And then we've got some singles here. Ultra Prism. Crimson Invasion. And Forbidden Light. Oh, so edgy. So they're all Sun and Moon packs. So, yeah, let's just jump. Every time I say jump into it, I'm just channeling Philip DeFranco. Okay, so we're gonna take, there are basically 5 different ones, so we're gonna take those, put them over here, and we're gonna go through the duplicates first, just because you gotta save the dessert for last, you know? So, I really don't think that any of this matters, but we're gonna be technical about it. Also, a tip that for myself that I've learned. This is the 7th time I've done a Pokemon card opening video. It took me several episodes to discover that it just go with scissors, man. Don't try to open these packs with this highly sensitive microphone. It just makes a nightmare of sound editing for me later on. So you still get a little bit of crinkly goodness just from scissors. But it's not enough to destroy anyone's eardrums. So, yeah. So, I always have this moment every video that we do. 1, 2, 3. The goal is always to get, basically the rare is always in the same spot out of the 10. So, how it usually is it's usually the 4th one down. So you take 3 off the top, 5 underneath, meaning this is now the rare. If you're familiar with Pokemon cards, you know that, but the thing is it's different, I think, for certain series. It's sometimes it's a different amount, so we'll see if this first one, if this is the rare, we did it right, but we'll find out. So, anyway, let's just jump into it. We've got also there's just a lot of pronouncing that who knows if I'm right or if I'm wrong or if you're wrong. It's all just whatever you want it to be. Okay. Illumise. Also, this video is particularly special to me because I watched Detective Pikachu today and really actually enjoyed it. It's not even like it was just such a stellar movie. It was by most standards, a good movie, but not incredible. But the fact that it was a live-action Pokemon movie that they did a really good job on, that was honestly enough for me. So, I'm happy about that. Would recommend if you're a Pokemon fan. I had a really good time watching it. Sneasel. That was a Shuppet. I didn't say that loud. We got Whismur. These are all garbage Pokemon so far. Ball toy. Bagon or Bagon. Okay, oh, this is a reverse. Which means, okay, we did it right, because this is our energy on the back. That's right, I forgot these ones included energy, so we did it right. We got a reverse holo Skitty. I might have to move my light back. I think it's reflecting too much. Okay, so Skitty, and our rare is Regice, I guess. Regice. Oh, and then we got a psychic energy. Alright, so the first pack, nothing too crazy. Alright, Celestial Storm number 2. What do you have for me today? Oof. Okay, so we actually should be doing basics so far. No stage 1s or stage 2s. Meditite. Okay, hold up though. Why is he pink? Is he a shiny? Is that a thing in cards? No, he still wouldn't be pink though. He would be white. I don't know, man. I'm just going off of Pokemon Go at this point for this guy, because in Pokemon Go he's white with blue, but if he's the shiny variant he's white with red, and I know that because I caught one. But this one he's pink and blue. I don't know. Seedot. Still all basics. Clamperl. Actually don't know if I've seen this Pokemon before. Sparkling Pearl. Is its only for 10 damage. Lure Ball is a reverse holo. And our rare. Oh, what the? This card is beautiful. Wow, look at that. Sorry, talking to myself. Rainbow Energy. It's a full. The full card is a holo. I've actually never seen one of these. Who knows? Maybe this is really special. Let me know if this is special. Maybe it's nothing, but man, it looks really cool. Rainbow Energy. That's awesome. Alright. Pretty happy with that. should I say? Wabbit. same setup I used as last time, so I'm just gonna assume you can see it. A lowland Vulpix, and look at that, and a lowland Sandshrew right after that. I really like the lowland evolutions of these two. A lowland Ninetales and a lowland Sand Slash. The Icy Sand Slash and the Icy Ninetales are both really cool looking. Alright, we got a reverse holo of the Floatzel guy. The Sea Weasel. What a weasel. Okay. Okay, you ready for this? Oh, we got an actual holo Infernape. More special, the like full art, like EX cards, or just regular holos like this, because these, in my experience, have been way more rare. I feel like I've gotten like at least one or two EX cards every video, but I feel like this is one of my first holos, just regular holos. That's really cool. I don't know if I had an Infernape yet, so I feel every other, like, non-holo, nothing special, pretty cool looking, special looking, non-holo, boring, and then cool. So this pack, if you keep the pattern, is gonna be nothing special, but then, ooh, this pack, buckle up for that one. Alright, so we got, Crimson Invasion, with the little origami man on the front. It's, I've said it before, but Gen like 6 and 7 are both not very well known to me, so I see stuff like that and I'm like, yeah, alright, that might as well exist. These days and their weird pronunciations. Okay. We got a Digger's Beak. It's funny having read these names so many times and then you suddenly have to say them out loud and you're like, ooh, yeah, I guess I didn't really think about that. Alright, reverse holo, yeah. Beedrill, wow. Did not expect a Beedrill at all. I never expect to see Stage 2 Gen 1 Pokemons in these Sun and Moon packs, but here we are, a Beedrill. Pretty soon you're already gonna get my binder out and just need to look at all the cards I have now, because I had a bunch, and then I started doing these videos, and now I have a bunch on top of the bunch, and I haven't really put them all together yet, so maybe that'll be my next Pokemon card video, is just looking at what we have. slept for 1,000 years in the form of a tree before its revival. I'd probably sleep for 1,000 years if nobody ever woke me up. That's dope. We got two holos and a full holo energy, which I still don't know if this is significant at all. It just looks so cool to me that I'm like, it's gotta mean something, but it's also an energy card, so I know it's a rainbow, so it's like all of them, but I don't know. Okay, forbidden light. Killing it right now. I don't want to stop. Come on out. Don't be shy. Uh-oh. Okay, I was like, we just messed up the order. We've doomed ourselves. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4. And the energy's on the bottom. Energy, just like this one. Wow, cool name, Lady. Very simple and to the point. What does this do anyway? Search your deck for up to 4 basic energy cards, then, oh wait, reveal them and put them into your hand, then shuffle your deck. That seems good, right? Yeah. It's actually been since I played the actual game. Well, it's probably been about a year exactly. Hoopa! The Sanders Lab. Esper. Like 3D, like real life artwork styles that just confuse me. Like it's clearly a real photo of grass, and then clearly they actually made these guys out of like, I don't know, clay or something. Yeah, it looks like clay or plastic or something, styrofoam even. And they just set them in some real grass and took an actual photo of them. I like that you're taking some creative liberties here, but it's jarring when you go through 50 cartoons and then suddenly you're looking at someone's lawn. Okay, reverse holo is Malamar. Look at that big boy. Overturning Pokemon. It lures, it's hard to read with the holo on there, it lures its prey close with hypnotic motions, then wraps its tentacles around it before finishing it off with digestive fluids. You see what I'm saying about Pokemon being suddenly hardcore? I don't know, man. They were cute when I was a kid. What is this, huh? Straight up flying kraken that just lures you in and sucks your juices out. Okay, anyway. Here comes our rare. Can we get 3 good ones in a row? Oh my goodness, we have another hole. Good row. Good row. Good row. once again, I'm not sure if just the artwork being holo is good or bad. I know that it's better than a non-holo completely, but I don't usually get just these kinds of holos, so that feels cool to me. So we've gotten three in a row. He's got 160 HP. His attack does 80+. If this Pokemon was healed during this turn, this attack does 80 more damage, so it can do 160 if it was healed. Also, its ability is whenever you attach a water energy card from your hand to this Pokemon, you heal it for 20. So its ability is it can heal, and then if you heal, you can do an extra 80 damage. It's a dragon Pokemon. It gets picked on because it's meek, but then whoever teased it gets to feel the full force of its horns and a good swatting from its thick tail. Nice. Cool. Wow. So we're out of the six, four good openings so far. So these are some pretty good rates here. I actually usually have decent luck in these videos. I get comments most of the time being like, I wish I had this guy's luck, and I'm like, shoot man, I wish I could be lucky like this on things other than Pokemon cards, but I'll take what I can get. Alright, we're back to Burning Shadows and then Celestial Storm next, so the ones we started with, we will now end with. Okay. A Pokemon from their hand to evolve one of their Pokemon, put three damage counters on that Pokemon. Togedemaru. I have no idea, man. Togedemaru. Of the whole, all the interactions with Mr. Mime in the movie are fantastic. It's actually just one couple minute scene, but that was probably my favorite part of the movie. You get a little snippet of it from the trailer, but honestly the best parts happen after the moments that are in the trailer. I would recommend, if you're here watching this and you're interested in Pokemon, go watch Detective Pikachu. I think you'd like it. I had a really good time watching it. Not sponsored, but god dang, I would love a Pokemon, or, you know, anyone would sponsor me. Panseer. Okay, reverse holo. This is our second reverse holo. Duskull. Yeah, we got one here. This Pokemon takes 30 less damage from the attacks of your opponent's fire or water Pokemon. Alright, last pack. I'm hoping that we can go out on a good note, you know? But it does 70 more damage if you discard all the lightning, all the electric energy off of him. So you could stack energy on him, and then you could spend it all and do 140 damage for a Lantern, which I consider to be not a Pokemon I thought to be very strong. That's he can hold his ground. Switch your active Pokemon with one of your benched Pokemon. Holo. Videos, I'm worried that I'm just gonna get like 8 packs of just nothing of note and be like, hey, thanks for watching, bye. Like, you know, of course I asked the person creating this video for you to watch. I can only hope that I get something worth the anticipation, you know. So I'm glad that we were able to get pretty lucky on these. So yeah, I love doing these. packs, I think, is a good amount for this video. It makes it a good length. If you want more of these videos, let me know. I kind of go off of A, the requests, and B, you know, I have to take into account just how many views things get, because I don't want to go posting things that nobody's watching, you know. That does play into it, but these always do pretty well. So anyway, thank you so much for watching. I will see you guys in the next video. I will probably do a video of just all my Pokemon cards soon, because I have just in my bookcase, I have all the stacks from previous videos that I need to put into my binder. And I also just want to look at my binder to see what else I have and kind of organize it. So that'll probably be a video at some point. If you want to see that, let me know. But anyway, thank you guys for watching. I'll see you in the next video. Good night. This is your captain, signing off.